Bienvenidos a Pico Escondido. Welcome to Pico Escondido, Young Life's camp in the Dominican Republic. Pico Escondido is located in the central mountains of the island, in an area that draws Dominicans year-round to enjoy its beautiful countryside and temperate climate. Pico is being built to do just what our Young Life camps in the US and Canada do, to create a platform for the presentation of the gospel in a safe and adventurous environment, where kids will have the chance to hear and respond to the gospel without pressure or intimidation. Hi, I'm Jacob Salmon, Guest Services Coordinator here at Pico Escondido. The Dominican Republic is a great place to step into the lives of kids. Of the 9.7 million people in the country, over half of them are under 25 years old. Nearly 12 years younger than the median age in the U.S. So the need for youth ministry is huge. Unfortunately, it's not a great place to be a kid. A common picture of a kid involved in Young Life, or Vida Joven as it's called here, is this. A teenager who lives with several half-brothers and sisters, but does not know his true father. They live in a two or three room house, apartment, or shack, with a concrete or dirt floor and no indoor plumbing. Their mother works to support the family, but the kids have to pitch in as well. 60% of grade school kids do not go on to high school, and 40% of high school kids drop out before graduating. Dominican kids in this situation live in a world with few options. On one hand, there is the strong temptation of drugs, violence, and promiscuity. At the same time, there are very few fun activities available to them that are both safe and legal. These kids are in desperate need of a healthy outlet and positive role models. Their involvement with Young Life provides the healthy outlets of fun activities, community, and mentoring. Their relationships formed within this context point them in a positive direction and provide a vital connection to the life and hope that Jesus offers. Vida Joven is most active in lower income areas, but the upper class kids that are involved have just as great a need for a savior. Getting kids interested in hearing the gospel doesn't just happen. It takes a relationship with someone they can trust and that has the ability to meet kids right where they are, that moves them to have confidence in the credibility of the gospel. Over the course of the school year and on into the summer, leaders are out there loving kids. They're on campus, hanging out in the neighborhood, at the playing field, in the kids' homes, on trips, and at club. Wherever teens are, relationships are being built. Kids know they are loved and they hear wonderful things about the person of Christ at club. But in the few minutes available for the brief club message, they don't get the whole story a young person needs to hear to give his or her life to Christ. Many ways, camp is the culmination of a Young Life leader's year-long effort to love kids. Within the context of a caring relationship with their leader, kids start off the week with a ton of outrageous activity, humor, and music, an introductory look at what life might be like in a relationship with Jesus. As the week progresses, the physical activity declines and the spiritual message intensifies. The whole Young Life camping experience is designed to give leaders the significant and uninterrupted time needed to share the love of Christ and for kids to consider the claim of Christ and the opportunity to begin new life in Him. Ultimately, scores of kids respond and give their lives to Christ, publicly sharing their decisions at camp. It is estimated that up to 40% of kids who attend Young Life Camp make decisions for Christ. Many of those reached just a few years ago are now working as Vida Joven staff and leaders in the very neighborhoods that they themselves grew up in. Like a bitter friend, it was all that I could do to keep myself from blaming you.
My name is Jose Ignacio Nolasco. I have the joy to be part of the staff of Young Life in the Dominican Republic. I have been working here for 7 months. I am the maintenance chief of the camp.
El personal de vida joven, tanto los norteamericanos y dominicanos, han estado encontrando y ministrando a los jóvenes en la República Dominicana desde 1986. La visión para la construcción de Pico Escondido ha sido fruto de las experiencias del personal de vida joven y los líderes voluntarios llevando a los niños a todo tipo imaginable de instalación en el país. Quedó claro que el Ministerio Nacional en Expansión necesitaba un campamento en que todo sobre el campamento comunicara que Dios valora a cada niño como su invitado especial. Un lugar donde todo lo que un niño experimenta, desde la belleza de la ubicación, instalación, animación emocionante, buena comida, camas cómodas y una forma humilde del personal y los líderes que sirven en el campamento, reflejará la gloria de Dios y servirá como un digno sitio para la presentación del Evangelio. Aunque está todavía en construcción parcial, Pico Escondido es un campamento que funciona completamente para los niños de la República Dominicana. Muchos niños ya han encontrado a Cristo y comprometido sus vidas a Él a través de los campamentos de nuevo en Pico Escondido. Campamentos de nuevos, campamentos de crecimiento para los nuevos cristianos, campamentos de entrenamiento para los líderes voluntarios, son ahora una realidad que Dios ha dirigido y utilizado de gran manera en las vidas de los jóvenes dominicanos. Además, durante todo el año, cuando Vida Joven no está utilizando el campamento, Pico Escondido sirve con las iglesias y otras organizaciones cristianas de todo el país, de toda denominación, proporcionando un entorno para campamentos de jóvenes, retiros y conferencias. Estos grupos locales siguen siendo no solo sorprendidos por la belleza natural de Pico, sino también por el alto nivel de la artesanía puesto en el campamento. Dios despertó a muchas personas a ser parte de su construcción. Mucho de lo que estamos viendo aquí en el campamento ha sido completado por los equipos de trabajo de los Estados Unidos. Además de ayudar a construir Pico Escondido, algunos de estos equipos también ayudaron apoyando el ministerio local en varias ciudades a través de proyectos en los barrios donde el personal de Vida Joven trabaja directamente con los niños. El impacto de estas experiencias ha llevado a algunos de estos misioneros a corto plazo a servir de tiempo completo internacional. Además de los equipos de trabajo de los Estados Unidos, los contratistas dominicanos se utilizan para construir el campamento con la dirección de experimentados Young Life Camping personal de los Estados Unidos. Cuando se haya completado, Pico Escondido será capaz de albergar 200 niños y líderes, hasta 35 equipos de trabajo, equipo asignado y staff, y 10 huéspedes adultos. El desarrollo de Pico Escondido avanzará a un ritmo necesario para satisfacer las necesidades del ministerio directo a los niños, ya que se expande a nuevas áreas.
Hi, I'm Roy Clifford, camp manager at Pico Escondido. I've been on staff with Young Life in the DR since 1998. We present these pictures and words to you today to share how Christ is moving in the lives of kids in the Dominican Republic. If you've been impacted by what you've seen and heard, here are several ways you can be involved in Pico Escondido and Vida Joven. You can financially support the Dominican staff and volunteers who are dedicated to meeting and befriending kids to introduce them to a real life in Christ. Consider bringing a work team to the Dominican Republic to help build this special place and to meet and be impacted by wonderful people of this country. U.S. missionary staff at Pico Escondido are here to develop the camp and train nationals to operate and maintain the camp for the continued ministry of Vida Joven. To not be a burden on the camp, our financial support comes from the Body of Christ in the United States. please consider being a financial and prayer partner with one of our missionary staff. Pico Escondido has grown significantly over the past few years. New construction will match the pace of growth of Vida Hope, requiring additional funding for each new project. A master plan is in place to guide the path of development. Labor costs are much lower in the Dominican Republic, which means we can build a great camp at a much lower cost than comparable construction in the United States. Thanks for taking the time to see what's going on with Vida Joven and Pico Escondido. We would love to have you as a partner in sharing Christ with Dominican teenagers. If you believe that God is moving you to participate, please contact us at the following address.